I think turning 21 is a really important rite of passage because you, you'll never get that back. It's like that feeling of losing your virginity, maybe. I don't know. It's like you're something you're never going to not be able to do again. So the thrill ride is kind of over, but now you're in this like exclusive club, and it's just a crazy release. I think the thing that is so relatable about this film is the friendships that last forever, that come from your childhood. Those are your closest friends. They're there for you when you need them, yet they're also there to call you on your BS. And that element is there throughout the whole movie, underneath all this craziness and mayhem. So I think it grounds the movie and gives it a really big heart.
I think this movie is relatable because we all go through that time in our lives where we have like the one crazy night of partying where you're like, oh my God, do you remember that time when we were all together and we did this? And you know, and it's like, and remember, oh my gosh, that night I made out with that guy and he was so hot. Do you remember what his name was?
And Skylar, like, and I was Skylar. Like, thank you, yeah. It's a weird name for a guy.
But like, you know, it's cool. Like, if you haven't had that experience in your lifetime, then, you know, this movie's really fun to be like, I kind of want that experience. And if you have, then it's like, yeah, I remember that time.
Casey is, I think Miller's moral compass. I think he's the conscience that Miller sometimes neglects. And it's that thing that they bicker like an old married couple, like, and I think that's because Miller gets so defensive because he knows deep down that Casey's right, and there's that kind of like older brother younger brother complex too there.
Pretty awesome. I bleeped. Did you like it?
The best ever.